Hi friends, today I want to discuss one of the topic from design of structures too. The topic is column bases. Column bases are structure elements used in the design of steel structure to transfer the column load to the footings. Two types, slab base, gusseted base. The column bases transmit the column load to the concrete or masonry foundation blocks. The column load is spread over large area or concrete or masonry blocks. The column bases should be designed with utmost care and skill in the column. Slab bases are used where the columns have independent concrete pedestals. A thick steel base plate and two cleat angles connecting the flanges of the column to the base plate. In addition to these, web cleats are provided to connect the web of the column to the base plate. These web cleats guard against the possible dislocation of the column during erection. The ends of the column and also the base plate should be mechanized so that the column load is wholly transferred to the base plate. Next one is gusseted base. Gusseted base are provided for columns carrying heavier loads requiring large base plates. A gusseted base consists of base of reduced thickness and another one is two gusseted plates are attached one to each flange of the column. The figure is shown. Next one is design of slab base. The design of slab base consisting in finding the size and thickness of slab base. In the procedure given below it, assume that pressure is distributed uniformly under the slab base. Size of base slab. First one is find bearing strength of concrete which is given by 0.45 fck. The second one is area of base plate required that is equals to PU by 0.4 fck. We know that PU is factor load. The third one is select the size of the base plate for economy as far as possible keep the projections A and B equal. The next one is design of gusseted base. The following design procedure may be followed. Area of the base plate is equals to factor load divided by 0.45 fck. The second one is assume various members of gusseted base. In this, A, thickness of gusseted plate is assumed as 16 mm. The B, size of the gusset angle is assumed such that its vertical leg can accommodate two bolts in one vertical line. C, thickness of angle is kept approximately equal to the thickness of gusset plate. Third one is width of the gusset base is kept such that it will just project outside the gusset angle and hence length is equals to area of plate divided by width. The fourth one is when the end of the column is machined for complete being on the base plate, 50% of the load is assumed to be transferred by the bearing and 15% by the fastenings. Fifth one is the thickness of the base plate is computed by flexure strength of the cricket critical section. Thank you.